if you search for something like best pizza Berlin, this is how we search Google. I don't know about you. I don't type in like a natural language like, hey, please help me find, you know. So if I go on google.com and I type best pizza Berlin, how's that going to work? Well, BM25, I don't know what algorithm Google uses, to be fair, but if it's, let's not say Google, if I submit this query, best pizza Berlin, to a BM25 algorithm, then how it would choose what to surface is it would give a very high score to like a restaurant guide that uses the word pizza many times, 10 times. That would be a very good document to surface. If that document is like 50 pages long or just a very big document, then the score would lower. And if every single page says best in this document, then it penalizes it. Yeah, because if everything's the best, then nothing's the best, and this is some marketing hype. So this is literally how BM25 works. And so why that matters is you're matching on keywords, but also the use and abuse of keywords. Are the keywords too much? Are they overused? And so on. That's super important. In the case of a document, for example, going back to our COVID example, COVID-19 treatment protocols for immunosuppressed patients, well, then any exact matches of that, so COVID-19 treatment protocol plus immunosuppressed patient, any exact matches would rise to the top. If those pages are too long, then there will be a penalty. But if the important thing is it matches on the keywords. Does that make sense? It doesn't match on some interpreted meaning. It matches on those exact keywords. And this is a contrast to embeddings and vector embeddings that we literally just talked about that match not so much on keywords, but on semantic meaning. And if in this case, if we ran COVID-19 treatment protocol for immunosuppressed patients through a vector search, exclusively vector search, we might get a bunch of COVID-19 treatment protocols. We might get a bunch of treatment protocols. We might get a bunch of immunosuppressed, immunocompromised patient treatment protocols that have nothing to do with COVID-19, because the weighting of each keyword is not substantial. It's more the weighting of the sentiment. And it sounds like you're just looking for a treatment protocol. Here's a bunch of treatment protocols. This is where vector embeddings can fall short. Does that make sense? And hybrid search is great because, or rather, keyword search is great because it prioritizes the keywords. Just again, to recap about embeddings, it captures the sentiment. So for example, if you search just with the vector search for like puppy, then young dog works, even dog works. If you search for tiny home with an embeddings model or vector search, then small house will be yielded. These are just different words, but that's how they work. Meanwhile, if you use BM25 or keyword search and you search for puppy, then puppy rises to the top, not small dog. Does that make sense? If you search for tiny home with keyword search, then small house is never... Does that make sense? So this is the difference between vector search, similarity search, and keyword search, which is usually powered by the BM25, best match 25 algorithm. So you could take, for example, one or two of these and combine them into what's called hybrid search. And this is really the best of both worlds, right? If we go back to the case of treatment protocols for COVID-19 patients who are immunocompromised, your vector search is going to yield you a set of results that may be inaccurate. Your keyword search is going to yield you a set of results that maybe aren't capturing the full semantic context. And so hybrid search is literally combining both of these, and then there's one more step that we'll talk about. But does that make sense? Like, if we consider the query for puppy, right? Same thing. Vector search will give you young dog, or just dog, if you don't have enough data. And keyword search would give you stuff that literally just matches puppy. And as a result, you have these two result sets that you got from somewhere. Finally, to tie them all together, you need something called re-ranking. And it's called re-ranking because you have two sets of results. You have a semantic similarity result with vector search, and you have a keyword density result with BM25 or with keyword search. And so you have these two result sets. They are ranked already. You concatenate them. These are my ranked results. And you present them to what is called a re-ranker. Okay, what's a re-ranker? A re-ranker is just like another AI model, believe it or not. It's just a machine learning model that is used for adjusting the rankings of a hybrid search result set. And so what happens is you present your both result sets to a re-ranker, and it will literally go through and understand, okay, hey, which documents here make sense, and will assign a score to them. For example, you could search for stainless steel fridge. Or for example, even better, if you're searching for like a chef mixing ingredients, right? You could search for a stainless steel fridge with keyword search or a durable metal refrigerator with embedding search. You get back a bunch of results. You combine them. You present them to a re-ranker. And a re-ranker is going to give you a confidence score based on both. So what you could do, what a re-ranker might do, is take the BM25 score per document, which both algorithms BM25 and vector search give you a score. So it'll take the BM25 score, multiply it by like 0.6, plus take the embedding similarity score and multiply that by 0.4, sum those up and give you a total. This is the new ranking based on both search result sets. And so when you do that, what it's going to do is also then compare that to the user's query, right? And so this boosts accuracy. So hybrid search is the gold standard. It boosts accuracy by 45%, as we can see in some research. And so let's consider this. How would a re-ranker work? How would hybrid search work for pizza search? I'm so excited. I'm speaking faster than my mouth. We've been talking about pizza for a while. So if we take a search query, vegan cheese pizza recipe, we take this and we give it to a set of embeddings search or vector search and keyword search models. Then the vector search, vegan cheese pizza recipe, it could give us vegan recipes, it could give us vegan cheese recipes, it could give us pizza recipes that are not vegan. Similarly, if we give the same vegan cheese pizza recipe to a keyword match, it will just give us vegan cheese pizza recipe documents and rank them accordingly, but it may not capture like the broader context, the feeling of it, okay, and the semantic meaning of it. And so what's going to happen is let's actually walk through this perfectly. Instead of the recipe, even let's look at a real example. I don't know how many of us cook, but I know a lot of us eat. And so if we look at the example of researching, hey, where can I find vegan pizza near me? If you give this to a BM25 keyword matcher, then it will find the best pizza in Berlin. Vegan or not, it doesn't matter, because what's happening? Pizza near me or pizza Berlin is amplified, and pizza is mentioned 5 times, and so that's probably going to be at the top. Again, because it ranks documents that repeat keywords not too many times, but repeats keywords and especially exact matches of keywords to the top. So BM25 is going to yield you like one result, best pizza in Berlin. Second result is a vegan bakery menu near me. Here's a vegan bakery near me, right? That's how these things work. So result number one, best pizza in Berlin. Result number two, vegan bakery, which is not pizza. And so what am I supposed to do with this? Well, the first result mentioned pizza, the second result mentioned vegan. We have that. Now you give the same query, vegan pizza near me. You give the same query to a semantic search or vector search model, and you get back a plant-based Italian restaurant. Notice I didn't use the word Italian restaurant. I didn't use plant-based, I used vegan. But again, this is capturing the vibe, not the words. So it will yield you like, here's a plant-based vegan restaurant near you or Italian restaurant near you. And it will also yield you, here's some dairy-free dining options. So the BM25 gets you the best pizza and the vegan bakery. The embeddings gives you a plant-based Italian restaurant and a dairy-free dining option near you. And both of these are like, okay, cool, but like, which one is vegan pizza near me? This is where hybrid search makes it better, because it re-ranks everything. It literally looks at all these results and then ascribes them a score that is relevant to your query. And the re-ranker will literally check, okay, now which of these actually serve pizza based on the returned results? Which are truly nearby, because you said near me, and which have good vegan items or reviews, or does it say vegan somewhere in this returned corpus of text? The re-ranker is going to do this and then assign a score to your result sets, hence re-ranking them, and ultimately gives you the most accurate results. And so that's how hybrid search works and can solve this problem.